So, till now we have learned what is an FMCG, what is SAP data extraction, and how do the SAP Oracle ERP process, ERP system, how it helps to extract data and transfer it to the Excel where we do our final analysis. We had a huge amount of data. We saw there was descriptive data and financial information was also given along with it, around 88,000 plus rows and 15 columns. Then we did the preliminary mapping of the data, in which we extracted the year and month from the period column, and then we had created an output structure, which we basically a report which we want to present to our client, and then we adjusted and we formatted the layout and the appearance of the report so that it becomes more presentable. And also we inserted formulas and automatic calculations to our worksheet. So a quick summary: this was the data which was given to us. Then we did the preliminary mapping. By now, what is mapping? Mapping is basically, it is used to give a particular code to a particular object, to a particular diff basically to identify different objects, different items. And similarly, here we have different items with different packaging, different sizes, and so to give different code to each item, we do the preliminary mapping. Basically, mapping was already done, the material number was already given, but then we had to separate the month and the year for our better understanding. And then we made the structure, we formatted the structure, and then we added the calculations to our structure. Now, in this particular video, we are going to make a pivot table out of this data. Why we are going to make a pivot table? Basically, because we want to fill this entire report. Now, this report, to fill this report, it is, you can say that we can directly use the data from here and we can fill this report. But then you'll see in coming two videos that how pivot table is very helpful to fill these kind of tables instead of using large calculations, large formulas, which we can do over here and extract the data from our data sheet, but then it becomes very cumbersome. And how using pivot table simplifies this particular method of adding the data to our report. Now, basically, what we want 2015, what was the total volume sold? 2016, what was the total volume sold? So all these things we want over here, and at the same moment we want to analyze it for different brands, for different clients, different client types. For that we use pivot table. In this particular short video, we are going to make a pivot table. Now, how to make a pivot table? It's very easy. I have this preliminary data sheet with myself. Just go on A1 first cell, click Control A so that your entire table gets selected. Go on the Insert tab, Pivot Table, and here you have a small dialog box. Select the table or range, yes, done. And you want it on a new worksheet, yes. I'll just click OK. And see, I have now a new sheet of my pivot table. I'll just rename this particular sheet as Pivot Table, and it's done. And what you can do is, for better understanding, let's take year in the column labels. Now I have both the years. As you all can see, I'll just expand the size. This is 2015, this is 2016, and I can also have months. So I can also drag month below the column label. So now I have months also. As you all can see, 12 months for both the years. 2015 has 12 months, and then 2016 has 12 months. The next, let's suppose I want the analysis to be done on brand, on different brands. So I'll take brand, I'll drag it to the row labels. I'm sure you have seen my pivot table basic videos, because this is how you make a pivot table, and I've explained it in my short video that how we do that. The next thing which we are going to do is we are going to insert the values. So I'll insert all my values, because all my values are important for my this particular table. So I'll just you can drag it to over here also, the sheet. Yeah, so I'll take volume. See, the once I tick on this particular box, it automatically comes down to the values section. So I'll just have to tick gross sales, discounts, net sales, cost of goods sold, distribution and warehouse. So I'm done with my basic pivot tables. This is 2015, your month 1, 2015 month 2, month 3 and so on. I can just click on this particular button and here you go, and you have only 2015 all the values of sum of volume, sum of goods sold, etc. And similarly for 2016, I'll again click on this plus option so that it's distributed monthly. I get the monthly distribution. Obviously it's a huge data. Why it is a huge data, I'll explain you all. Because 2015 has 12 months, right? And in each month, I have these 7 values of volume, gross sales, discount, net sales, cost of goods sold, distribution and warehousing. So for each month, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 columns for each month. यानी कि इसका क्या मतलब है, हमारे पास 2015-2016 का डेटा है, हर ईयर में 12 मंथ्स है एंड हर मंथ का हमारे पास 7 कॉलम्स है. सो 7 इंटू 12 एक ईयर का एंड इंटू 2 फॉर द 2 ईयर्स. तो इतना सारा कॉलम्स वी हैव इन दिस पर्टिकुलर पिवट टेबल. एज यू ऑल कैन सी, एज यू ऑल कैन सी कितना ईजीली. एंड सम ऑफ 2016 सम ऑफ वॉल्यूम, तो ये जो है ये पूरे 2016 का फिगर है, ये जो है ये पूरे 2016 का फिगर है फॉर दैट पर्टिकुलर ब्रांड. अभी भी देखना ये ब्रांड वाइज है, हमारे जो रो लेबल्स है दैट इज ब्रांड वाइज एंड डिफरेंट ब्रांड्स है ये एंड दीज आर द डिफरेंट मंथ्स एंड डिफरेंट ईयर्स. सो दिस इज हाउ आई हैव मेड माई पिवट टेबल. इन माई नेक्स्ट वीडियो आई शो यू ऑल कैसे हम पिवट टेबल यूज़ करके अपने कैलकुलेशन वाले शीट को पूरा फिल करेंगे.